Hello everyone, this is your host Mahmoud Nawair and welcome to Nawair Yudarris. What does Nawair Yudarris translate to? It means Nawair teaches. I'm doing these series of videos in biochemistry, physics, organic chemistry, chemistry, behavioral sciences. As you can see, these are the topics of the MCAT, but I'm doing them for both the MCAT and for anyone who wants to understand these topics. So this is the first of many videos. So today we're going to start with biochemistry. We're going to start with enzymes. Alright, please bear with me, and I hope I do a great job. Alright, so enzymes. Enzymes don't impact thermodynamics, they just lower activation energy, increase reaction rate, don't alter equilibrium, alright? So, you use enzymes in a reaction to lower the activation energy, alright? So it doesn't require as much energy and it doesn't take as much time to initiate the reaction and for it to complete. So enzymes only impact activation energy and the reaction rate. Other than that, they don't have a lot of effect. So, oxidoreductase catalyzes the oxidation reduction reactions and often acts as an NAD plus electron carrier. So this is just like a general group of enzymes, and under it falls other enzymes. So you got transferases. So catalyzes the movement of functional groups to another, such as kinases transfer phosphate of ATP to another molecules. So I want you to think of it that way. Transferases, it transfers, it catalyzes movement of functional groups. So transferases, transfers. Okay, hydrolysis. So you've probably seen that word before. Hydrolysis involves water. So breaking of compound into two molecules using the addition of water. You got lipases, nucleases, peptidases. Alright, moving on, you got lysases. So catalyzes the cleavage of a single molecule into two products. So you got one product, let's say you got product A, it breaks down into two products. So you got B and C. Isomerase catalyzes the rearrangement of bonds within the molecules, such as stereoisomers. We'll be talking about that shortly. Ligases. So you've probably seen that word before. Ligase is basically like sticking things or combining things. So it catalyzes the addition or the synthesis between large molecules, but it requires ATP. And it happens during nucleic acid synthesis. So, to review all this, oxidoreductase catalyzes oxidation reduction reactions, right, from its name. Transferases catalyze the moving of functional groups. Hydrolysis catalyzes the breaking of compounds into two molecules using water. Lysases catalyzes the cleavage of one product into two, and isomerases catalyze the rearrangement of bonds, such as stereoisomers, and ligases catalyze the addition or synthesis between two large molecules and happens during nucleic acid synthesis. Alright, next you got the enzyme substrate binding. Alright, for an enzyme to affect an active site or a molecule, it needs to bind to it. So that occurs through an active site, and then you got a substrate binding, and you got numerous types for this. So an active site has a certain spatial arrangement for a specific enzyme. So not any enzyme can just come in and then stick itself in the active site and it work. There are special arrangements for specific enzymes. So one of the first ones is lock and key. So an enzyme's active site is specific conformation for a substrate to bind. Then you got induced fit model. As enzyme and substrate come together, the enzyme changes the shape of the active site, even substrate changes the shape. The reaction occurs, then substrate are released and the shape returns. So in the induced fit model, basically when both the enzyme and the substrate bind to activate the enzyme, what happens is the enzyme changes its shape to match the substrate or to match a certain conformation, and the substrate as well changes its shape. Once the reaction occurs, the substrate is released from the enzyme, and then the enzyme returns to its original shape. Right. What are cofactors? Cofactors help in catalysis of reactions by carrying charge through ionization. Alright, so you got, for example, for a cofactor, you got apo enzymes are enzymes without cofactors, and holoenzymes are enzymes with cofactors. So you got two, apo enzymes, no cofactors, holoenzymes, enzymes with a cofactor. Here you got vitamins. All right, what are vitamins? Vitamins, you know, vitamin C, vitamin D, that probably the doctor prescribed you, or you take off the shelf vitamins. So vitamins are coenzymes. You got vitamin B, vitamin C, NAD plus, and FAD. All right, there are two type of vitamins: fat soluble vitamins, which are nonpolar and hydrophobic, such as vitamin A, D, E, and K. All right, so fat soluble vitamins, nonpolar and hydrophobic. Then you got the water soluble, vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin B2, riboflavin, and thiamine. So two types of vitamins. All right, now we came to the Vmax and the Km, the concentration. All right, and the reactions Vmax. So the more substrate added, the faster the reaction, until all the reaction and all the active sites are full. That's the Vmax. So how do you increase the reaction rate? You add more substrate. When you add more substrate, for instance, you have two enzymes, all right, and then you want to increase the reaction, you add 10 substrates. So the chances of the substrates binding to the enzymes is going to be faster than, for instance, if you added two. So it's faster, increase it, gets to the Vmax and increases the enzyme's initiation. So V is equal Vmax divided Km, and high concentration reflects low affinity for substrate, meaning an increase in the enzyme activity. Now you have a term called cooperative. Cooperative enzymes have multiple active sites from multiple all subunits. You know, enzymes are different, there is a lot of them. So a cooperative enzyme, if it has more than one active site for substrates, it means it requires more substrates to bind, so the affinity for the substrate binding increases. And if it has one or less, after one substrate binds, the enzyme could block the second active site or decrease the bind affinity. And if you just have one, it means no cooperation, the enzyme is not cooperating. It means it's just, this is the one you bind, I do my reaction, and then we're done. So cooperative is enzymes that could have multiple active sites and multiple subunits. Right. Enzymes are directly proportional with temperature, so every 10 Celsius degrees, enzymes doubles in velocity. And pH can denature enzymes and can affect the shape of the substrate. So extreme high pH or extremely low pH can result in loss of activity. So a really acidic or a really basic conditions could really affect and denature the enzyme and the substrates. Salinity can also cause disruption in the hydrogen ionic bonding and could cause the denaturation. So you got two factors that can cause denaturation. You got salinity and pH. And remember, when temperature increases, the enzyme doubles in velocity. All right, now the feed forward regulation. right? What's feedforward regulation? It's the substance of the previous enzymes activate the inactive enzyme of the other reaction in that pathway. What does that mean? It means that an active enzyme will activate an inactive enzyme in another reaction in a pathway. Let's say, for instance, molecule A is active, and in order to activate molecule C, you need to activate molecule B, and molecule B is only activated by molecule A. So molecule A will activate molecule B, and molecule B will activate molecule C. So you got molecule A will activate molecule B, and then molecule B will act and activate molecule C. Alright, what is reversible inhibition? You got three, you actually, no, I'm lying. It got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 reversible inhibition. I got you there. You thought it was three, it wasn't. So 5 reversible inhibition. So what does that mean, just in general? So inhibition is basically an inhibitor that binds, or something that blocks the activity of the enzyme or the substrate, affecting either concentration or Vmax. Let's explore this together. So the first type is competitive inhibitor. That's an inhibitor that binds to an enzyme and blocks substrate by attaching itself to an active site. So basically, you got an enzyme, right? This is the active site. And then, for instance, this is an inhibitor, blah, blah, blah. An inhibitor comes and occupies the active site. And then you got the substrate. The substrate is like, what about me? I'm supposed to be in the active site. So in order to overcome this, you add more substrates. You keep adding more substrates. Add more substrates to increase the affinity that the substrate is going to bind instead of the inhibitor. Right? So what does this do? It increases the concentration value, but Vmax is unchanged because Vmax is related to the enzyme. So it doesn't really matter how many substrates you have. The substrates only affect the concentration value, but with Km, it's just related to if the enzyme is triggered, activated, or not. Then you have non-competitive. So basically, what is non-competitive? Non-competitive is an inhibitor that binds to allocentric site and blocks the enzyme from doing its work, and the substrate binds to the active site. As you can see here, let's say this is our enzyme, right? The same inhibitor binds to the side here. And then we got our friend, the substrate. It comes. Oh, what am I supposed to do? Why is this not working? Why is this not activating? All right? What's happening here? So the inhibitor binds to an allocentric site and blocks the enzyme from doing its job. So we said that Vmax is concerned with whether the enzyme is activated or not. So since the enzyme is not activated, Vmax value is going to be altered, probably going to be decreased because there's one less enzyme that it's not working. Km is not altered really, because it doesn't matter if you increase it or not. There is still there is nothing that is occupying the active site. Then you got mixed inhibition, right? What is mixed inhibition? It's an inhibitor that binds with an unequal affinity to the enzyme or the allocentric site. Basically, it can bind to this or that. It can bind to the active site or the allocentric site. In both cases, Vmax decreases, Ka, and the concentration increases or decreases depending where the inhibitor binds. Then you got uncompetitive. The inhibitor only binds at the allocentric site. The Vmax decreases because the enzyme is not working. Well, like, what am I supposed to do? You know? Nobody wants to bind here because they want to work. So, substrate wants to bind to me. And then lastly, you got the irreversible alters the enzyme in a way that the active site is unavailable for the time, so no substrates can basically attach itself to it. At the end of the video, I would like to thank you, and I'd like to ask you to just put in comments for future things I can improve on, and don't forget to subscribe, and thank you so much. Check our TikTok as well, it has short segments, and please like and share your videos. Thank you.